All right, we got...
We got Sacrifice. This is a music video, right? Yeah.
No, this is not a music video.
It is.
No, it's not.
I bet you $1 million.
How are you going to bet me an amount of money that you don't even have?
I'll find it.
When...
Or you'll find it, because
So you basically, if you think you're going to win, you'll bet money you don't have? That's what you're saying, right?
No, I bet money I'm going to get...
Right, but if by a small chance that you lose, you don't have
There's
money
no
to cover
that's
your
how,
bet.
That's how sure I am.
That's a dangerous way of living life. I see. So you're just an ass better, right?
What's that?
An ass better is like you're betting money that you don't have. That's what an ass better is.
Knowing that I'm a win.
Right. Everyone thinks they're gonna win in certain situations.
No, like I'm 100% sure.
Right, but there's going to be a time where you're 100% sure, and then that 1% comes along where you're
then
not.
I wouldn't bet $1 million.
I see. What if that was just like a thumbnail and that was an actual video? You'd be sick.
I'd be sick.
You'd have $1 million that you can't even cover.
But and I think I saw the music video.
So really, you're not 100%.
No.
You're like 99% because of a thumbnail.
I saw the music video.
I see. All right, we got...
We got... Did you clap?
Yes, I clap.
We got The Weeknd, Sacrifice.
Remember Creed? That's what I think of when I think of Sacrifice. Remember that group, Creed? It's like a rock. I don't know if I would consider them rock.
I remember Creed, but they were like soft rock.
Soft rock? It was like a soft... There's a soft rock and hard rock, right?
Yeah.
It's a lot of...
And then there's like extra hard rock. I think that's like metal.
Yeah, rock has such a huge spectrum.
It makes sense because there's so many different types of rocks.
Yeah. So many different types of rocks. Yo, dead. All right, let's get it.
You are now listening to 103.5 Dawn FM. You've been in the dark for way too long. It's time to walk into the light and accept your fate with open arms. Scared? Don't worry. We'll be there to hold your hand and guide you through this painless transition. But what's the rush? Just relax and enjoy another hour of commercial-free music on 103.5 Dawn FM.
I don't know what it is, but this reminds me so much of like the Truman Show.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. Or like, Eternal Sunshine, Endless Eternal Sunshine. Yeah. Like one of those like future, like not futuristic, but like dystopian,
like these
utopian movies almost.
Yeah, they're like false realities, right? Yeah, like the Matrix, like you think it's a reality, but it's really not. I mean, it's more based on delusion. And that's why I liked the Truman Show and the Matrix, because they're based on like this false sense of reality, and when they finally figure out like, oh, this isn't real, it's an eye-opener.
And then you always have that like one person that's, wait a minute, this isn't right. Mm-hmm. And it looks like it's The Weeknd.
Yeah The Weeknd is Neo right now. He's either Neo, he could even be Morpheus. Yeah,
like a young Morpheus.
Yeah.
Painless transition, but what's the rush? Just relax and enjoy another hour of commercial-free music on 103.5 Dawn FM. Stay tuned.
Oh my God. I love that this is like continuing on after Take My Breath.
Life's always with me. The ice inside my veins will never bleed. Love.
I love that line. Like, every time you try to fix me, you're never gonna find that missing piece. As if to say, like, there's a part of him that's missing and it's gone.
Oh, I literally thought about, like, when you, like, build something and you try to fix it, but you never find that missing piece. Like, that fucking sucks. Like,
yeah, yeah. But you don't find it because it's not there to be found. Yeah, you know, like, it's gone. And that one line really, it reminded me that he's from Canada.
Mm-hmm. That makes me think of Snow Child.
Yeah, because they're known for being able to, like, withstand the cold. Definitely a lot better than most of us Americans, you know. They're just built for a different type of winter.
Find that missing piece. When you cry and say you miss me, I'll lie and tell you that I'll never leave. But I sacrificed your love for more of the night. I tried to put up a fight. Can't tie me down. I don't wanna sacrifice for your love. I tried.
Oh my God, like, he gives me so much, like, Michael Jackson vibes, especially right there. Like, it's crazy.
Yeah, I know this. He's also very theatrical, right? Michael Jackson was very theatrical, especially for his time, right? Like, you can't really compare someone to Michael Jackson during that era. Like, this era now, like, we produce some pretty, I want to say, like, pretty big artists, right? Like, as, like, music evolves, like, you see the artist evolve with the culture.
Mm-hmm.
You see it with, like, athletes, and you see it in other domains as well.
Yeah, the bar is set really high now.
Yeah. And I think as artists continue to improve, like, our idols obviously are pushing us to, like, go further. Like, I think of sports right away, right? Because of Michael Jordan, you had all these other players that idolized him and tried to reach that level. And then you have the Kobe Bryants and the LeBron Jameses of the world, because that comes from, like, idolizing someone as great as Michael Jordan. You need to set that bar really high to even be able to strive for something that good. And then as that bar keeps getting higher and higher, like, people have to push higher and higher. And I think that's why these artists are so good today.
It makes me think about, like, record times. Record times are always, like, getting beat. It makes me think about that story where, you know, that one record wasn't able to be reached until someone did it.
The 4-minute mile.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. It wasn't, they said scientifically, like, it was impossible to beat. One man beats that 4-minute mile. After him, hundreds started beating
it. Yeah.
Because they seen it was actually possible.
Yeah.
I hold you through the toughest parts when you feel like it's the end. Cause life is still worth living. Yeah, this life is still worth living. I can break you down and pick you up and fuck like we are friends. But don't be catching feelings. Don't be out here catching feelings. Cause I sacrificed your love for more of the night. I tried to put up a fight.
Hey. My God, who does that dance?
Michael Jackson.
Is it Michael Jackson?
And Bruno Mars, right?
I see. I feel like I'm referring to Chris Tucker, a cartoon character.
Chris Tucker, no?
Chris
From
Tucker.
Rush Hour?
Oh, yes. I think it's Chris Tucker that I see.
He's like dancing like Michael Jackson.
I see. Oh, I didn't know. So that was all inspired by him.
I think
like
so.
Like he's the, like originated that. I know he originated the moonwalk. And then there was just like various versions of the moonwalk
I'm pretty sure it's Michael Jackson.
I wouldn't
Yo,
be surprised.
This fucking video is interesting. Like it seems like his soul is like really being like sucked from, you know, somewhere. And like the character that's in red, it seems like they're like a sorcerer or something, trying to like feed off of his youth or something.
It's very Matrix like, right? Because you use red, like that signifies like that red pill, that dose of reality. Or I think that,
or Handmaid's Tale.
Well, I never see it. I never really got far in Handmaid's Tale, so I don't know what
the handmaid
symbols,
like they wear red. Like red is a huge theme in that book.
I see.
Yo, this is like really insane because as he's singing, like you see like this aura that's like really being sucked, and then you see that the red character was old at one point and then becomes young, and I really think that it's because it's being fed from him.
I see. That makes sense. The one thing I noticed too was like you've seen the chain.
Yes.
On his hands, like he was like chained to the microphone.
Yeah.
Which I think indicates like how strong music has a hold of him. Like he's chained to this microphone. Like music is, and it's funny because I think I remember it was J. Cole who said it, where like his ambition is like a gift and a curse, where he always has to like write because his mind just takes him there. It's what got him so far. But it almost sounds like it holds him hostage in a way because it's an obsession that he can't really get away from. Mm. And I think artists tend to be that way. Like you hear these painters, they can develop like these mental disorders, especially like back in the day during like the 17th, 18th centuries. These really good painters had like mental issues sometimes too.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah. I forget who, but. Anyway.
You're talking about like the Van Goghs,
mm-hmm.
and like the Monets.
I don't know exactly who, I forget.
Like Picasso.
I just remember reading about some shit like that.
That's so interesting. And then you know, when he talks about like, I don't want to sacrifice, I love my time. Makes me think about like him sacrificing like his youth or like time, like like wasting his time. Like he doesn't want to waste it almost.
Which makes sense, right? It's why he has this picture of him being old as the cover. Because
mm-hmm.
time's important to him. And he knows it's limited. It's the only thing we can't buy more of.
Yeah.
That's why it's like depending on how you look at it, you have to look at time as if it's your most valuable commodity, because in reality, it actually is. That's why I get mad at people that like try to use up more time to save money, when I think you should be doing the opposite. Try to spend money if you can save more time. I mean, also depending on what you're doing with your time. If you're not doing shit with your time, then like disregard that whole notion. But like for someone like The Weeknd, your time is very valuable. You sit there, spend hours writing or making music that's very fruitful, right? Like he produces art that reaches millions of people.
Like therapeutic.
Yeah. For some, it might be someone else's like suicidal ending.
Yeah.
Like he makes great like suicide music for sure.
Yeah, it's really dark sometimes.
Yeah. Or like even if it's just like...
It's weird because like in my darkest times, like I really relied on his music, and it actually made me feel like I wasn't alone. And so like I wouldn't say I was suicidal, but I was pretty fucking low. And so for someone that's, you know, suicidal and they're listening to music, sometimes I feel like it is in a way very therapeutic because it allows them to kind of feel what they're feeling and hopefully be able to express it, where after you express it, you feel a little better.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. And that's what I mean when I say suicidal music, like someone that's going through the feelings or like the suicidal ideation, when you hear someone else feel that way, it grounds you. Like, you know, I'm not the only one that goes through this.
Yeah.
And that essentially saves you.
Yeah.
And that's what I mean, like suicidal in the sense of like, not that you're actually doing suicide, but like you feel like that's actually an option. Because that's, you know, obviously before anyone kills themselves, it becomes an idea first before you actually execute on it. But like, depending on what you're going through, like these type of mediums, like music, can really ground those feelings. And you can say to yourself, like, oh, this person felt the same way. And look where they are now after dealing with that and after just enduring that. Because that's the hardest part, is just trying to endure that phase. It's a very hard phase when you feel like suicidal. It's because you're going through something very difficult. And sometimes it can be very hard to see like that light at the end of the tunnel.
You know? And I think that's why it's so important when people that are in that stage in their lives, when they listen to like people that are in like, you know, the celebrity status, or like anyone that you meet, when you realize that they're also going through the same thing, there's like some sort of relief. That's why I think these like groups, these support groups are so beneficial, because it's this feeling that like, wow, like I'm not the only one. There's other people dealing with a very similar or same situation. And so, yeah, there's a lot of benefit to that.
Yeah, I agree with you 100%. I don't think we realize how universal our problems are until we hear someone else speak about their story. And that's why people that speak on their story, sometimes like they get so much attention. Like it's hard to talk about certain things. And that's one of the things you don't really talk about unless you know how to express yourself. And not everyone's that gifted in a way where you're able to articulate your feelings in a way that's received well.
Yeah, and it takes bravery to, you know, unravel like the ugly truth, right? Like no one wants to really talk about their struggles or, you know, something that sucks in their lives.
Yeah, they rather talk about someone else's struggle, you know, like seriously, it's hard to talk about your own shit.
Yeah.
It's always easier to look at someone else's shit, like, let me dissect someone else's trauma, you know. So it's definitely needed, because when we're able to relate to other people in the world, we get a sense that like, it's okay because everyone goes through this, or a lot of people go through this and they come out fine, and maybe I'll come out fine. You get that inspiration that you can keep moving forward. At least it helps you cope like day by day, at least, because you can only take it a day at a time anyway.
It makes me think about people in the military and like the relationships that are built off of going through such a intense part of your life, you know, like that sense of brotherhood from doing something together as well. It's very strong.
Yeah, yeah, that's a great point. And it ties into like your theory with support groups. That's why support groups work so well, because it's all community based, all of it.
Yeah.
You know, and when you're in that community, when you have a club of people, a group of people that share the same values or beliefs, it just makes going through life that much easier.
And then that's...